I think it's established fact now. It's good evidence-based practice early intervention. There are good and solid research that demonstrates that it's possible to reach these patients earlier in their illness development. And if you provide the decent treatment in the early phases, it works better than if you provide it in the later phases. So there's an international agreement now that the best thing is to provide good, decent, evidence-based treatment so early as possible. The most important step is to meet these patients very early, because it makes it so much easier to establish a relationship with them. And of course the interpersonal relationship is maybe the most important condition for a long-term favorable outcome in these disorders or disturbances. So to meet them early, get a good rapport with them, and also provide a tailored treatment to each and one. You have to provide what we call stage-specific treatment. You have to have an eye for what developmental phase is this patient in, and you have to then map the stressors in his or her life very early. And maybe the first thing you do is to look for the stresses and try to reduce the stress, identify and reduce the stress in this young person's life. I know that it's possible to do this in other countries as well. In Denmark, they have a lot of early intervention services. They also have a national strategy. In the UK, they have a strategy for early intervention in psychosis. I just visited the US, and in 49 out of 50 states in the United States, they are now developing early intervention systems, and some of them are copies of the Norwegian system.
With the same results?
They don't have results yet, because it's so early in the US. But you have even better services, I think, in Australia, in the Melbourne area, and they have developed a system called the Headspace organization, and they have centers all over Australia, and that approach has also spread to many other countries like Norway, Denmark, UK, Ireland, France, etc. So this way of thinking and this way of organizing the practice is spreading all over the world these days. Singapore, Hong Kong, etc. As you say, in Norway, almost all of the health services are public and funded by the state, that is funded by tax that we all pay. And we have a rather big and large public sector in Norway and in Scandinavia. And I think it is necessary to have a good funding of the services. And I think people in Norway think they get their taxes back, in a way, through what we consider to be a very good health service system, both the somatic system and the mental health services. So there is what I would say good and solid funding of the public health services, and it's for almost all people, it's almost free of charge as well. So it's, and especially for the young people, it's totally free. They don't have to pay anything to use the services, to approach the services. And also the services are spread all over the country. It's equally shared between the more distant parts and the cities, where the more densely populated parts. So I think it's based on equality in all terms, and it's also based on easy access. So I mentioned these treatment packages. That is a guarantee that you will get the assessment within a very short period, some days only. That is for the more serious mental disorders, as well as for the more somatic disorders as cancer and so on. So I think there's a direct direction between the very strong public sector, people willing to pay the taxes to fund the sector, and what they get in return through these, I would say, good health services. For example, when we made up this last edition of national guidelines for psychosis, then we had this big economy company going through what would be the cost or what would be the savings. And they came up with a report that showed that if people follow these national guidelines, if you provide what the guidelines say, they will save billions of Norwegian kroner for the government and for the state. And when it comes to early intervention, there has been done a lot of economic evaluations of these services, and they all unanimous show us that if you establish a good early intervention service, then the state will save money and the paid people will save suffering, so to speak. So it's a win-win situation. And there are quite recent data from US research on the first US early intervention services that show the same. You save a lot of money by doing early intervention.